So over the past week, I was able to get my hands on an RX 6600 XT. So I thought I will do some testing with it. And I wanted to answer some questions that I thought people might have with this GPU. The first question, would an RX 6600 XT be a good upgrade for somebody with an old CPU? So for this, I tested the RX 6600 XT and also the RTX 3060 on an old CPU, the i5-4690K. Now the second question, which of those two cards would you choose? Would you choose the RX 6600 XT or the RTX 3060? And for this, I tested this on my newer PC, the i9-10900K that I've got right here, and the results were really interesting and I'm looking forward to sharing those results with you in this video. Okay, so if you like this video, make sure to hit the like button and also subscribe to this channel for more videos like this. And we have a Discord server, so come along and join us there. And I'll leave a link in the description below. So here are the specs of the two systems I'm testing. I won't read it out, so we can get as quick as we can into the results. Obviously, the biggest difference is that the i5-4690K is a 4-core, 4-thread CPU released back in 2015, and the i9-10900K is a 10-core, 20-thread CPU released in 2020. I'll be using the XFX RX 6600 XT Speedster Quick 308, and there is a factory overclock on the clock frequencies. I'll also be using the Palette RTX 3060 Dual, which you may recall was the one I accidentally cut the fan cable, so if you want, go and check that video out. This has the same clock frequencies on the GPU core as the reference model. Right now in my country, both GPUs are about the same price of about $750. As you know, mining has a big influence on the pricing, and both are capable of about 30 megahash a second, though on the Nvidia card you'll have to unlock that to get that figure. I want to quickly touch on the methodology so you'll have a brief understanding of the tests I'm doing. Firstly, on the i5-4690K CPU system, I tested 5 games at 1080p resolution for both the RX 6600 XT and the RTX 3060. As I had less than 36 hours, I did not have enough time to test 1440p and 4K here, as I couldn't get dynamic super resolution to work on this system for the RTX 3060, so I had to abandon the testing there. Each test run was about 5 minutes long, and I only did one test run for each, but they look pretty reasonable to me. For the i9-10900K, I tested the same 5 games at 1080p, 1440p, and 4K resolution, and here we should see some scaling across resolutions, as the RX 6600 XT has a memory bandwidth of 256GB per second, while the RTX 3060 has 384GB per second. In terms of performance, according to Tech Power Up review, the RX 6600 XT should roughly perform on average 10% better across games at 1080p resolution, about 6% better at 1440p, and at 4K resolution 4% behind the RTX 3060, so it'll be interesting to see if all of this holds up. Alright, let's talk about the results. The first game tested was Cyberpunk 2077. I was curious to see how this Nvidia-sponsored title would perform. At 1080p, the RTX 3060 does perform better. However, I will note that this doesn't give a true indication of the two GPUs, as they are both bottlenecked by the CPU. In these frame rate charts of the game playthrough, you can see that the CPU utilization was 100%.
Slow two right long, tightens into open hairpin left.
Dirt Rally 2 was also interesting. Dirt Rally has performed better on AMD GPUs in the past, and Dirt Rally 2 continues this trend. While the CPU was not bottlenecked, it is interesting that the frame rates vary so greatly on both cards. And you can see that with an older CPU, frames aren't delivered consistently or smoothly, leading to a poor driving experience. Despite Metro Exodus being an Nvidia-sponsored title, it performs well on both GPUs, and the RX 6600 XT performs 25% better than the RTX 3060. The performance is generally pretty good on both cards, though there are some big drops, but the frame rate is high enough that it's not really that noticeable. Monster Hunter World performs better on the RTX 3060, though there was a section with the RX 6600 XT for the first 100 seconds where the CPU utilization was 100%. This could explain why the frame rate is much lower here, and it picks back up above 60 FPS after. That may have skewed the results, so just bear that in mind.
Mother, I bring you fresh prey.
You are so kind to me, daughters.
Finally, on Resident Evil Village, CPU utilization is really high. In both the 6600 XT and 3060 playthrough, the first 150 seconds were gameplay, and the second 150 seconds a cutscene. The gameplay delivers quite varied frame rates, but the cutscene frame rates are pretty smooth. So, is it worth it to get an RX 6600 XT or a RTX 3060 for an old PC? Well, I would say that you don't get the best performance if you just insert that GPU into an old PC. When you run out of CPU resources, generally there's a lack of smoothness, and then the game experience suffers. So, while it would be an okay stopgap solution, I think buying a new PC when you run out of CPU resources is best. And even if you get something like a 6-core 12-thread CPU, like an Intel 10400F or a Ryzen 3600 or 5600, I think that would make a big difference to the game experience. Let's go through the i9-10900K results, and I won't show the framerate playthrough this time, as in general the framerates were pretty smooth, but if you want to check those graphs out, see the Google spreadsheet in the description. For Cyberpunk 2077, the RTX 3060 is the better choice at all resolutions. That said, this is a game where both GPUs are better suited for 1080p. It's somewhat playable at 1440p at high settings at around 37-39 FPS, and it's not really playable at 4K, where the RX 6600 XT is down to 13 FPS. For Dirt Rally 2, the RX 6600 XT is the better performer at all resolutions. The title is also very playable at 1440p on both GPUs, and it's really only at 4K where RX 6600 XT's performance lead is reduced. That said, this 1080p framerate chart shows very varied frame rates on both GPUs, though probably worse on the RTX 3060, and it was the same on 1440p and 4K. So the game has a very fluctuating frame rate, and performance can be disappointing. In Metro Exodus, the RX 6600 XT is the better GPU at all resolutions. The lead is actually the largest at 1440p, indicating that the memory bandwidth is still fine on older titles at 1440p, while the lead is reduced at 4K. It's the same story in Monster Hunter World. The RX 6600 XT performs much better when the CPU is not bottlenecked, and here the lead is 34% at 1080p in favor of the AMD card. However, that lead is quickly pegged back at 1440p, though the RX 6600 XT is still leading, and at 4K the 3060 takes the lead, but not really at very playable frame rates. Finally, we have Resident Evil Village, where, full disclosure, I didn't get very good results here, but I decided to show as much as I could anyway. For example, for the RTX 3060, the frame rate was locked to 144 FPS or below, and I couldn't work out how to disable this. Here, only the 4K result for the RTX 3060 shows the true performance. However, if you're worried, know that Resident Evil Village performs over 100 FPS at 1080p and 1440p anyway. Another problem I had was I could not enable 4K resolution on the RX 6600 XT, so I wasn't able to get a result here. However, 1080p and 1440p results were fine. Overall, the RX 6600 XT delivers the performance it promises, and that being that it's 10% faster than the RTX 3060 at 1080p. I was actually surprised that at 1440p, it held up well in pretty much all the games except for Cyberpunk 2077, which is a difficult game to run anyways. So I think the RX 6600 XT can be recommended as a 1440p card for now. As for 4K, well, I don't think these cards are 4K cards because they generally don't deliver 60 FPS. Okay, so in conclusion, I don't think it's a good idea to put a new GPU into an old PC and expect great gaming performance. Secondly, the RX 6600 XT and the RTX 3060 are both great 1080p cards and fairly good 1440p cards. At 1440p, I'd probably still recommend the 3070 or the 6700 XT, though of course that really depends on your budget. So finally, is the RX 6600 XT better than the RTX 3060? Yes, it is, and at first I thought the lower memory bandwidth would lower performance, particularly at higher resolutions like 1440p or 4K. But these are 1080p cards, and I don't think the lower memory bandwidth really matters here. So I think the RX 6600 XT is the better choice at the same price. Now, for ray tracing, I don't think that's really a priority here, given that you want to be spending most of your GPU resources on game performance. And as for DLSS and FSR, well, they both look really good at high or highest quality settings, so I think you can't really go wrong either way there. At 1440p, the 6600 XT still has a bit of performance lead in most titles, and at worst, it is equal here. So I think at 1440p, it's still a pretty good card. And for 4K, well, I don't think these are 4K cards anyway, so I don't think it really matters here. Okay, so if you like this video, make sure to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this, and I'll see you in the next one.